All right, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to get started with Google My Business Post. This will be very quick and you'll be up and running in the next few minutes. This is a new feature from Google and allows you to do a quick micro post, almost like a little mini blog post, or really, if you almost think about it, like a Facebook status update, that kind of thing. And it's going to show up with an image, and it's going to show up in your search results for your company's name, things like that, as well as in some cases in Google Map search. So it's a really neat way to get some messaging out there and put a spotlight on specific things. Most people are going to use them for, you know, like events, special offers if you're having a sale, maybe even product updates, like you have new merchandise or something is in the store, or just announcements in general. Say you're closed on 4th of July, you could make that messaging clear so people are seeing that before they even visit into your site. And lastly, you could probably do content marketing. So for instance, in a test that I did, I went in and highlighted a recent guide that a client had posted on their blog. All right, let's go take a look at this live and I'll show you how simple it is. When you're in Google My Business, you're gonna see the normal things, your insights, your traffic, and also hat tip to Woodside Health and Fitness. They are a local Kansas City health club and they are a client of ours and allowed us to log in as them to show you this video. So it was very nice of them. You're going to notice though, post, if you haven't been in here lately, is brand new. If you don't see it, just hang tight, it's coming. It should be, by the time this is posted, rolled out to just about everybody, but if it's not there, just hang tight, it's coming. Also on the left menu, Google's drawing attention to this post here as well. So let's hit create post, and you'll see how simple the user interface is. First of all, images are going to be very important for this post type because they're a huge portion of it. Almost like, like I said, a Facebook post. If your image is kind of boring, it's not going to draw or attract much attention. Google says the minimum photo size is 720 by 720. So you're thinking square format. I would recommend a photo size larger than that. I would double it and go 1440 by 1440 just so you have a higher res image across multiple devices. So upload a very engaging image. Next would be the post itself. So you can do 100 to 300 words. I've tested it and it allows essentially up to 1500 characters with spaces. So it'll start cutting, it'll cut you off at 1500 characters. So usually that for me, that was close to 300 words, around 260 or so. So in that 100 to 300 word recommendation that they're doing, that they're giving is gonna work out. The next thing that you're gonna look at here is they have a special thing for events, and that's why, because this really does well for events, but this will give you a title, so a title tag that you can name your event, and you can do up to 58 characters and with spaces. And you also get neat features like you can pick the start dates and the end times. Really, really neat for events. And I think a lot of people are going to initially use this for events. However, let's say you're not having an event. They have this button option. And this button option, you have learn more. These are all different CTAs. Learn more, reserve, sign up, buy, and get offer. Now, if you click in on any of these, you're going to see that it's just a link. So in my example that I used, I just linked to a guide that they had put up on the benefits of exercising with friends on their blog. You'll see that, I'll show you in just a second, the live example. So all of these are this way right now. You just put in a link of where you're wanting to go. I'm sure they'll expand this. I've seen some people say that there is a call button. I haven't seen it yet. So maybe that's not rolled out for everybody yet, but that would be really cool, like a click to call. Right away button. So really, really cool stuff. And I'm sure they'll, you know, expand these features as we go. So let's take a look at a live post. Now, if you click in here, you can edit your post. You can delete a post, which is really nice. And I just published this, so it's not, there's no insights yet, but they're actually gonna give you some analytics. So you'll have insights for each of these posts. If you click view, it'll take you to it, but I'm logged in, so I'm gonna go in incognito view so I can show you how this looks out in the wild. Here we go. I've Googled Club Woodside, and you can see all the information that's pulling from their Google My Business account. Here's some of their events, and boom, here's our post. So this is showing up really, really, you know, predominantly. The image is engaging, colorful, and it's simple to use. If you click the Learn More, you're going to be taken right to that blog post that I was mentioning about, this guide on exercising, the benefits of exercising with friends. I like that Google made this simple. They could have added a lot of bells and whistles to it, you know, but hey, if you want to make a huge blog post, you're going to use WordPress or something like that. So this is just an easy way, something to add into your toolbox if you're a local marketer or local SEO that you can get an instant benefit from. When I hit publish on this post, it was instantly available in the search results. So that part is really, really cool. And down in the comments, let me know how you plan on using this. Maybe link me some examples. Show me some events that you've posted or announcements or content that you're pushing. I want to see some of the creative ways people are using this and how they implement it in real life. I look forward to seeing your feedback. Thanks.